when it goes offloads to the actual port and hits the land, or when it hits the boat, like a tugboat, or the crane, when the crane touches it, let's say it touches on 11:59 midnight, is that when it, when the import when the entry date is, or is the date of entry when I bring the paperwork to customs while it's sitting there? What if I don't want it in Los Angeles? What if I want it in Miami? And I ship it to Miami on a railroad or in a truck. For me, when I the date of entry cannot be date of entry for Miami instead of Los Angeles. So do you see all those questions that are revolving around? And this is why it's very important to depart to be critical when you see something which is word, which is combination of words such as date of entry or time of entry. I suggest you think of it as a term of art. In other words, you cannot just by looking at the date of entry tell, yes, in fact, it's the date of entry. You have to look at the surrounding circumstances. So what are those circumstances? Well, again, this is preliminary. We're going to get to this in more details in the future, but look at this. Entry summary is one of the customs documents that you need to file. Also colloquially known as, well, officially known as CBP 7501, but apparently when you have submit the paperwork and you get the release, that's the time of entry, we shall see. What if you don't do that? Well, the moment you have the release of merchandise and the moment you file the documentation and the moment you ask on the documentation to treat that date when you give documentation the date of entry and the moment, here is a critical one, within a, it comes within the port limits, if all those four conditions are met, it's the date of entry. What if you haven't, let's say you didn't request on entry documentation when you filed, you submitted the documents saying, customs, please release, here is the documents. I want, but you forgot to say, I want this. Customs says, okay, great. And again, we're talking about the paper world. Electronically, it's just the same. It can be just the same. But in paper world, customs is busy. Let's say they have a lot of other things to do, and they have limited resources, so they put it off, and they come back to it next day, and only next day they put a stamp on it, released. Because you forget to put that request on, it came in not on the day one, but it came in on the day two. And in the world of customs examination, that day two and day one will usually be the borderline between when higher and lower duties take in the, go into the effect. It can go either way, but that can be so. If you are the customs broker and you could have done the clearance on the day one at the lower duty rate for your client, then at the day two at the higher duty rate, would your client be much more happier if you cleared it on day one? And all you have to do is just make that request. And how do you make that request? Well, if you're doing it on paper, you just write it down on the form, on the 3461. It's one of the customs forms. Electronically, same thing. Servers go down. Servers go down. Happens all the time. If you are curious, go to cbp.gov and sign up for electronic messages. You'll see a bunch of electronic messages coming to you. Or entry processing is delayed for technical reasons, etc., etc. And just like that busy customs officer who is overloaded with work and has no time to process everyone instantaneously. So we are seeing electronic world having also a bunch of problems. So it can be applicable either way. So this is why it's important to treat the date of entry and time of entry as a label. Here is another label. Date of exportation and or time of exportation. And as you can see, date and time here, they have the same meaning, because usually whatever takes change, whatever changes, it go. It may take by an hour, change by an hour, but usually for customs purposes, it will be usually the day as a unit. If it is, you have to go break down further. I think you may recall my conversation about business hours, right? I remember I said that there is another question of business hours to restricted merchandise. Well, because it's restricted, and by restrictions, I'm talking about something which is either restricted for political reasons, such as, or economic reasons, such as sugar, sugar cane, raw sugar cane, or for other reasons, industry protections, like cheese, all right? It has certain deadlines of entry. So what if everyone wants to bring sugar cane? Are people in Hawaii better off bringing sugarcane than people in New York? If you adopt, okay. Right now it's let's say it's 9 o'clock. Let's say it's 6 o'clock in New York. What's the time in Hawaii, in Honolulu? Hawaii is another state. Yeah, usually I'm the one who whenever someone would ask me like, I'm the one who would jump. So yeah, it's 12 o'clock in Hawaii, and the response is, well, how do you know that? Because I'm thinking about Hawaii. It's palm trees, nice and warm, and it's a beach, sand, all those nice things which people associate with pleasant thinking. But in the business world, in the capitalist world of efficiency, we may associate this with, oh, 6 hours, wait a minute, if I submit sugar, and I know the quota, right? So you have, let's say, X amount of tons to import. I know that I want to import everything so everyone else is out of luck. So of course, I may want to bring my ship on a detour to Honolulu, and clear it in Honolulu, because by the time there will be one quota opening period, let's say 8 o'clock in New York, I'm already 6 hours ahead of the game, right? So this is the time. This is so in that case, the rules when I call you the date and time, they really have the same meaning. In situations like that, when hours count, they do really deviate from the general rule of having equivalent weight, because it would be very unfair for New Yorkers to have Hawaiians have a first try to take a first shot. So what they do is they do allocations. And we're going to talk about that later. But aside from this exception, usually when it says date, exportation and time exportation, it usually means the same thing. And of course, one may ask, exportation, wait a minute. Do customs broker exams, examiners, are they asking a lot of questions on export, or is it mostly about imports? Imports, right? But of course, import is a relative word. Every import must have an export. So you import something into the United States, you export something from China. So it's a relative concept, right? So it would be me doing you a disfavor to you by just leaving it this date of exportation, time of importation. So let me put the ground rule here. Whenever I state something as import or export, it always has a reference to the United States as a center point. So in this case, date of exportation with exportation see here for the United States. So here it would be date of exportation from China, let's say, to the United States. But if I don't say otherwise, it will be exportation from the United States to, let's say, Mexico. And this is important. Why? Anyone? Why do we need? So we know, we talked about label of importation, date of entry, let's say. It's important because it says bunch of, may set bunch of economic benefits or economic malfeasance to you or your importer. Or for that matter, on a customs broker exam, as far as points are concerned. What about the actual date of exportation? What's the deal with that? Sorry? Yeah. Yeah, what if you're doing it in renminbi, right? Or if you're doing it in euros? What if your invoice, remember I talked about the preliminary contract? What if it is written in euros? And euros exchange rate jumped during the time of voyage. Which one, can you just arbitrarily pick the one you like that's more favorable? Or US or licensed customs broker, can you pick the one you think your client likes? No. You lose points on the customs exam if you do that. Because the date of export and therefore the currency exchange rate is determined by the actual date of exportation. All right. Anyone sees any other problems with this word? We're not done yet. It's a simple sentence, but we're not done yet, guys. Can someone explain me the word actual? Is it like common sense when I say actual? If you notice, that's why I call it an outline, right? Because I'm not putting everything in. Because otherwise it'd be like the it'd be bigger than CFR. But what's the deal with the actual? Okay, so several issues, right? Several issues arise. So one issue that customs examiners found with a favor is, let's see. So what's this dot? Supposed to be Ireland. This is Iberia. This is Italy. And let's say it's Adriatic Sea. And let's say this is Athens, Greece. So the boat leaves Athens. It stops in, let's say, Rome. And then it stops in Barcelona, and then it comes into the, this is Miami. What's the actual date of exportation? Let's say you're using the container from Greece. Using the date of exportation of Athens, or using the date of exportation of Barcelona? All of them were like, can be deemed as actual, right? Which one? Anyone? Who is for Barcelona? The town where Olympics games were held, I think, in the 90s. Anyone is fan of Barcelona? No one? Yeah, they're going through economic depression. Let's not be depressed. What about Greeks? They're rioting, right? They're having economic upheaval, just like great people of Spain. But they're more in the news. Remember this island nation of Crete, where there was a big bank crisis. They are constantly on the news. So that kind of that's kind of like a rhetoric that I would go with Greece, all things are being equal. But to take the sarcasm away, I think the actual date would be the date which the merchandise leaves the country, its country, not on the way in between. Let me give you another scenario. And this is true for many steamship lines. Anyone flew to some place and they've been routed to one city, so they could change a plane and then go to another city. So let's say I want to fly to Miami. I find it cheaper for me to fly to Atlanta and then to Miami. Well, same thing in the shipping industry. A lot of them do what's called the hubs, the system of hubs. So in the case of Israel, I believe this is a symbol for Israel. It stops in Jamaica, where the ship either goes to North America, including the United States, or Latin America, such as Brazil. What's the actual date of merchandise finally the country of exportation? Well, Jamaica or Israel? Well, it depends. I haven't told you enough information. Did the merchandise enter the Jamaica and was assimilated into some other merchandise? Did anything happen? Did it enter the, what's another magic label, commerce of Jamaica? Or was it just container taken off from one ship and put on another ship without anything being done to the merchandise? If it was the second, not the first, then country of export is Israel. So you use that exchange rate when it left Israel, not Jamaica. What does it also mean? What if there was a high exchange rate fluctuation? If you're the creative broker, can you change the date, the currency exchange conversion lawfully? Well, how about trying to, again, I haven't done this, right? So I have to check, but one idea may be to enter merchandise into the commerce of Jamaica and then bring it back. For the purposes of currency conversion, it may be just enough to jump the exchange rate for the Jamaica. Of course, you have to do other instruments in between, such as reselling, et cetera, but it's a thought. Is it lawful? Does it seem kind of sketchy? Yeah, it feels weird. But is it being done? Well, if as long as we are not breaking any regulations, why not? Okay, next. So remember I talked about merchandise coming in, physically coming into the port vicinity, and I was asking, is it entry, date of entry or not date of entry? Well, there is more concrete label for that, which is date of importation. Because date of importation really talks about the physical arrival. It's not really the legal arrival, it's the physical arrival, physical coming in. So if it got, and of course we can see the different modes of transportation. Imported by vessel, when it comes within customs territory of the United States. What's within the customs territory of the United States if it's by vessel? Well, usually port limits are good enough. So if it comes let's say it comes within the port vicinity of Los Angeles, but does not offload because it has to wait in line, or New York Harbor, that's fine. As long as it comes in within the physical vicinity of the port, date of importation will stand. think I'm jumping my gun here. If it's airline or truck, when it comes to the United States, physically it comes. If it arrives by vessel, then within the limits of the port. So it's easy because if it comes by plane, when it comes to the airport, that's the date of entry. When it comes by truck, let's say from Canada or Mexico, it's physically there. With ships, it's a little bit more tricky because there is this waiting time and there may be more logistical impediments in place. So you really define as date of entry as being the one within a port.